everybody. I'm Lindsay Sildman, Senior Product Manager for Nikon at Photo Plus Expo 2016, and I'm here with the brand new 70-200 f2.8 EFL EDVR. It's one of our two new lenses that we introduced yesterday, and this one is squarely aimed at our professional and high-end photo enthusiast audience. This is one of those go-to lenses that sports photographers use, wildlife photographers use, wedding photographers, photojournalists. It's just a great, great focal length and always been one of their go-to lenses. So just when you thought we couldn't make an improvements to an already really great lens with a high reputation, they have. So first and foremost, a new optical formula. It uses 6ED extra low dispersion elements, a brand new fluorite lens element, and a high refractive index element. The fluorite element is lighter in its mass than ED, so it makes the lens slightly lighter, but more importantly, it adds better balance to the camera, to the lens, excuse me. So when you hold it in your hands, there's no top heavy, no front bending on the lens like it can be with the 70-200 current lens. So it's really, really nice in your hands. One of the things I like best about the lens is that the design switches the focus button, focus ring, excuse me, for the zoom ring. So, for me, I use autofocus and I touch up my manual focus, autofocus, quite infrequently. So my hand fits right where the zoom ring is now. On the current lens, that's where the focus ring is. So for me, real easy to zoom, come back, touch it up, come back and zoom again, because that's what I do often. Next improvement is we've put back these focus preset buttons. And with today's cameras like the A10, the D500, the D5, you can actually customize these buttons to the types of things you would envision yourself using most frequently. For me, I'm an AF on shooter. I use the back button on my cameras, and I use my thumb. I'm always on continuous autofocus. So I press, I focus, and when I want to lock focus, I lift my thumb off. With a lens like this, I've got these four preset buttons. So whether I'm holding the camera horizontally, and you can see my fingers just go naturally right over the button, both sides, or vertically, same thing, my hands are in a very natural way, I can control that feature that I just talked about, AFI. You can check the website and see all the complete compatibilities of what we can do with that, but it's really, really very, very cool. Another thing we've done is we've put fluorine coatings on the front and rear elements of the lens. So once again, our photographers who use this and know who you are out there, you shoot under really the craziest conditions, rain, snow, mist, shooting in the mud, all that kind of stuff, and you know that can play a part in picture taking. Moisture on the front element, moisture gets on the back element, really easy to clean, no smudges, really, really cool. And of course, it's got nano crystal coat. So when you add all that to the optical formula, a really, really tremendous improvement. That's enough for most people, but we can go on because we've also improved the image stabilization. Gone from 3.5 stops to 4 stops of image stabilization. Always a big improvement to do that. Allows you to shoot same situation at a little bit slower shutter speed or lowering your ISO, more importantly to me, maintaining high image quality. So 70-200 f2.8 EFL EDVR, it'll be on sale very, very shortly. Second lens, and don't mind me bending down, Dan, is a lens that's a more niche type product, but a super important product nonetheless. This is the widest perspective control lens in Nikon's history. It's 19 millimeters, and it means that's 97 degree angle of view. It's manual focus like all the PC Nikkors are, but for the first time on a lens like this, we have the ability to tilt perpendicular or parallel to the subject, which means now it doesn't matter if I'm holding my camera horizontal the way I am, if I shift the lens upward to correct for keystoning, which is the perspective control element, if I want to correct or enhance my depth of field, I can tilt the lens downward, okay, but now with the new control on the lens, I can also turn that turret and I can tilt the lens left or right. So it doesn't matter if I'm holding the camera vertical, horizontal, I can tilt up or down or shift it and tilt right or left. Really important. And it's important, and it's really important because, as you know, when you shoot at a really small aperture, there's a phenomenon known as diffraction. And diffraction is basically the light bending around the diaphragm blades. So while you're stopped down to f22 or f16 and you're getting increased depth of field, you're also degrading image quality because the image is not quite as sharp as it once was. By using the tilt control of a lens like the 19 millimeter f4e, What happens is you can shoot at wider apertures, f8 for instance, and still get tremendous depth of field, therefore improving image quality. And I think for architectural photographers, whether you're shooting exterior or interior, that's really, really important. So I'm excited about this just as much as I am about the 7200, because this is just quite a stunning optic for us. And it really rounds out our entire PC Nikkor lineup. In fact, they all have a gold ring on it. We're calling it the Gold Ring series of PC Nikkor because they have one thing in common. Nano crystal coat, our great optical coatings that's on our lenses that increases contrast and prevents flare. It's also in this lens. So we have the 19, the 24, the 45 and the 85, which by the way are also micro Nikkors as well. And so we round out that PC lineup with the new 19 millimeter lens.